When I first landed in Jamaica, I had a lot of preconceived notions about white sand beaches, non-stop red stripe, and a little bit of fear. But so much of that was wrong. I spent a month traveling this wonderful island with my local guide, Mikey, and I learned so much. Together, Mikey and I are going to show you everything you need to know to navigate Jamaica like a pro. We'll get you through the airport, show you authentic Jamaican food, cover safety, getting around, history, culture, LBGT travel, and all the other practical info you need to have the trip of a lifetime. There are two main airports in Jamaica, in Kingston, the capital, and in Montego Bay. I suggest flying into Montego Bay. That's the closest airport to most of Jamaica's tourist destinations. North Americans, Europeans, and Aussies won't need a tourist visa. If you're from somewhere else, you might, so please check. When I arrived, I breezed right through customs. But I had friends who waited for 3 hours. Customs and passport lines are Russian roulette, coming and going. But I've got a solution. Consider using Club Mobay. I'll link to their website in the description. It'll expedite your trip through the airport and basically eliminate the risk of waiting for hours. Plus, you get access to this really depressing lounge. Now that we've landed, let's get oriented. The island's a lot bigger than you might think. It takes 12 hours just to drive around it, and it's made up of 4 distinct resort areas: Negril, Montego Bay, Ocho Rios, laid-back Port Antonio, plus a secluded spot that most people don't even know exists, but was one of my favorites.
Remember, Jamaica, I think, is the 3rd largest Caribbean island.
Oh, I did not know that.
We've got a separate video breaking down what Jamaica beach destination is best for you.
So Michael, one of the things I want to do over the next few days as we're traveling around Jamaica is try some of the local cuisine.
Oh man, Don, we got some authentic stuff.
Yeah.
I encourage everybody to try some of the local stuff, you know, and Jamaica has a great food culture.
Most of the best meals I had in Jamaica were not in fancy hotels, but more local and authentic. Like this stop we did when I was river rafting with my daughter.
Thank you.
It's got a bit of spice. Sauce is beautiful.
It is really, it's probably super simple, and done over the wood fire is so good.
I've been in Jamaica for a week.
Hello.
This is the best meal I've had.
Thank you. I'm happy to know that.
Yes.
So, how do you get around this big old island?
My first mistake was to get in the car on the wrong side.
Yeah.
Because we are driving on the wrong side of the road here, aren't we?
Yeah, we are. the British left us with a legacy.
Yeah.
That we drive on the left.
Renting a car in Jamaica is pretty easy, but I recommend against it unless you're used to driving in foreign countries. Google or Apple Maps should be able to get you most places. The Jamaicans have also figured out how to make riding a bus more fun. So taxis here are a bit complicated, but I'll try my best. To be safe, I advise only taking the official tourist taxis that are operated by JUTA or JCAL. These letters will be easy to spot on the taxi. Unofficial taxis, also known as route taxis, are abundant and not as safe. And they can pick up many passengers with lots of stops. Think of them as really small buses. And some are fake, so that could result in you being cheated or worse. So I say save your money in other departments, maybe by drinking Red Stripe instead of Heineken. If you do want to take a local taxi, ask your hotel concierge to arrange it, and make sure the taxi has a red license plate with a P or a PPV plate, and an official badge. By the way, currently Uber is only available in Kingston. Life's too short for a bad vacation, so here at the Swank Guide, I've put together all the info you need to plan a great trip, including videos about the island's coolest boutique resorts, from low-cost hidden gems to ultra-luxe resorts, a video about 10 unique things to do in Jamaica, plus a video to help you figure out what part of the island's best for you. Welcome to Jamaican culinary heaven. I'm talking about Jamaica's most famous dish, jerk.
I've been driving around Jamaica for a few days now, and you see jerk everywhere. It feels to me like it's kind of the national dish of Jamaica. Is that true?
But jerk being very authentic to Jamaica.
Yep.
And what makes Jamaican jerk much different is that the way they season it the night before, then the next day, they're gonna put it on that grill.
Right.
And these are what even make it so authentic to Jamaica.
Right.
It's quick, it's easy,
right.
It's filling. If you do come to Treasure Beach, please check out Wasi jerk and pizza.
Yeah? Give me a quick promo. Thanks, man, that was excellent. Really, really nice. Appreciate the authentic Jamaican jerk. Does the name Jamaica mean something?
Oh yeah, they said it derived from a native Taino, uh-huh. who were like the Indians who were living here first.
Right.
Came from a word called Exmaya,
uh-huh.
which was translated into Jamaica, which means land of wood and water.
Land of wood and water.
Yeah.
Land of wood and water, I like that.
The first Europeans in Jamaica were the Spanish, and many towns still bear Spanish names. Then came the English, turning the island into a huge sugar plantation, built on the back of enslaved Africans who made Jamaica England's wealthiest colony in the Caribbean and the hub of slave trade in the Americas. Planters built great houses and lived decadent lives while imposing horrible conditions on their slave labor. But maybe the great irony is that although England ruled Jamaica for almost 300 years, the island's deepest influence isn't English, it's African.
Say one love to the world.
So Michael, what is up with all the red, green, and gold all over Jamaica?
It signifies the connection of Rastafari to Africa.
Yeah.
And so the red is for the blood of one blood for all earth.
Yeah.
Hence one love.
Yeah.
And then the green is for nature.
Yeah.
And the gold is for sun.
Nice.
So, you know, it's just a life. And we just think that, and we must give props to Rastafari who started tourism in Jamaica.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, that through reggae music.
Yeah.
And so forth, bring a lot of visitors.
Goat curry is another popular Jamaican dish you'll find almost everywhere. All right, now for some trivia. Ever wonder why Jamaica's featured in so many of the early Bond movies? Well, it's because Ian Fleming moved to Jamaica after World War II, and his estate has been turned into one of my favorite Jamaican resorts.
Michael, I have a question about safety.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people don't know. Like, is Jamaica a safe place?
I think for even though we have a high crime rate, I think for tourists in Jamaica, it's pretty safe.
I mean, let's just talk about like the major tourist destinations.
I think they're very safe.
Okay.
You know, like Ocho Rios is a mixed, the tourists mixed with the locals.
Yep.
Montego Bay a little different, the tourist is segregated from the main town.
Yep.
Negril, you could always be on that 7 mile beach
yep.
and go into anywhere. I think for tourists, if we read about crime against tourists, yep. it's hard to find yeah. a tourist that has been hurt in yep. Jamaica.
You give us maybe your top three tips for just staying safe in Jamaica, making sure you have a good trip.
Oh my, just stay on the main thoroughfare. Don't go down dark alleys.
Yep.
Don't wear a lot of jewelry
mm-hmm.
Going out.
Yep.
And hire a professional local guide that you can find online.
Like this guy.
Oh, you can find me online. My name is Michael Grizzle.
Expect to be hassled sometimes with people asking you to buy things on beaches or city streets. My advice is just smile, say no thanks, and keep moving.
Oh, no, I'm good, thanks.
Also, ladies, I wish this wasn't true, but females always have to be more careful than men. So use common sense and think twice about going out alone at night.
What do we have here?
We're having here, we have The P is ital. This is what ital in Jamaica, we say ital is vital.
Okay.
So we have the ackee. We have a little tomato run down, cooked down in the milk of the coconut.
Yeah.
And then we have some beans with carrots and pumpkins cooked down into the coconut milk also.
Yeah.
So it's strictly no meat. So you see, Jamaica has captured the entire Caribbean.
Yeah.
You know, that is what makes Jamaica so unique, is that it has the flavor of the entire Caribbean mixed in one super ball.
Yeah. So like a good friend of mine came to Jamaica a few years ago on a cruise, and he said, his impression of Jamaica is not very gay friendly. What do you think about that?
Yeah, I think Jamaica being a homophobic country,
So
it's pretty true, but again, that shouldn't stop you from coming to Jamaica. You're pretty safe in the hotel. Going out in the local areas, just exercise some form of discretion.
Yeah, probably don't hold hands, maybe no kissing in public.
And stuff like that.
Yeah, I mean, it kind of sucks that you got to do that, but I mean, just exercise some discretion, and I reckon you'll be fine.
Very fine.
Yeah, so not dangerous. And, you know, I've seen gay couples in resorts here.
I think within the hotels, the workers are used to having
gay couples
coming in.
Yeah.
These are called tasty patties. It's a competition between juicy and tasty.
Right. This is a Jamaican specialty.
Very, very specialty in Jamaica.
Yeah,
I think it originated in Jamaica.
Yeah.
And it's very popular because it's economical.
Yeah. Hey, let me see. Mm. Really good.
Yeah.
These are a little bit of spice, which I love. This is a really nice level of spice, not too much, but it's really nice. But since you have tasty patties all over Jamaica, on a scale of 1 to 10, what is this?
I would say between 1 to 10, it's like 9.5.
Ooh!
9.99.
Wow!
It's almost 10.
Oh wow!
Yeah. That tastes just like I would make vegetable in my kitchen.
Yeah, you guys, this guy—he's an expert. He is an expert on this stuff. So that's saying a lot.
Okay, let's shift gears for a minute into our speed round. As a former British colony, everyone speaks English. The local language is Patois, which is Creole, but very close to English. Credit cards are accepted almost everywhere except for places like roadside stalls. ATMs are ubiquitous. USD is accepted almost everywhere, and at most hotels, you'll see prices in USD. Outside of hotels, you'll find a mix of things quoted in USD and Jamaican dollars. You'll probably get a better rate if you pay using Jamaican. Even if you're not American, I suggest you bring some USD cash. Tipping's expected, 10% at restaurants. For a personal guide, maybe 10 to 20 bucks, depending on how long they were with you. Call your bank before you head out and tell them you'll be in Jamaica, so they won't cut off your credit card or block the ATM. In terms of dressing, Jamaica's a casual place. It's always warm on the coast, so dress like it's summer unless you're going to the mountains. Winter and spring are the dry season, but even in the rainy season, expect a lot of sun, unless there's a hurricane, of course. Hurricane season runs from the beginning of June to the end of November. Don't be like me. Bring water shoes for some rocky beaches and waterfalls. It's safe to drink the tap water unless you're in a very remote area. I don't want to dispense health advice, but dengue fever and Zika outbreaks have occurred, so please do a bit of research and apply mosquito repellent. I've put a link in the description to a helpful article about health. Hotel taxes and resort fees are some of the highest I've seen in the 65 plus countries I've visited. Usually the price you see quoted is not what you end up paying. It can easily be 15% higher, so make sure you understand the full cost of your hotel before you book. There's a $35 departure tax you pay when you leave. I know, it's annoying. Most places use the standard electrical voltage of 110, like the US. Plugs look like this. Junk food is available, and Mikey says it's the best KFC in the world.
Jamaica has the spirit when it comes to the herbs and spices and the way they put it together.
Drink Red Stripe, it's good and it's cheap, unless you're in a luxe hotel, and then it's 12 bucks. The peak tourist season starts in mid-December until mid-April, so expect to pay the most then.
Thank you, man. This has been awesome. I've learned so much about Jamaica. You have been the best tour guide, and I'm gonna miss you.
Gonna miss you, buddy.
Same here.
Here we go.
Okay.
If you love all-inclusive mega resorts, then plug your ears. But if you want to see the island's coolest boutique resorts and design hotels, you can see Jamaica's 10 best here.